class. Today we're going to learn how to solve two-step equations. We're going to build on what we learned last week when learning to solve one-step equations, and learning to solve two-step equations will help us as we move into solving multi-step equations later in the week. To start solving two-step equations, you first have to isolate the variable. Does anyone know what it means to isolate?
It means to have the variable alone.
Nice. So in this case, it would mean getting the x by itself. The next rule is related to addition and subtraction and multiplication and division. To learn which of these you have to do first from left to right, we use the acronym PEMDAS, which explains the order of operations. Does anyone know what the P stands for?
Parentheses.
Great. Does anyone know what the E stands for?
Exponents.
Does anyone know what the M and D stand for?
Multiplication and division.
And does anyone know what the A and the S stand for?
Addition and subtraction.
Great job. So we do multiplication and division according to whichever one comes first from left to right, and we do addition and subtraction in the order of whichever comes from left to right. So what will we do in this example to make sure that the x is isolated and that both sides of the equation are balanced and equal to each other?
We can subtract 12 from both sides.
And why are you subtracting 12 from both sides?
So that it stays equal on both, right?
Yes. So what is 30 minus 12?
18.
So 3x equals 18. Now, how would you isolate the x?
Divide by 3 on both sides.
And why are you dividing by 3 on both sides?
In order to isolate the x by itself.
And what is 18 divided by 3?
6.
Great. So x equals 6. Now let's make sure that our answer is right by plugging it back into the equation. 3 times x, which is 6, plus 12 equals, what's 3 times 6?
18.
What's 18 plus 12?
30.
Great, so 30 equals 30, and we know that our answer is right. I'm now going to ask you both to split up into pairs and solve the following equation. It is 9x plus 5 equals 50, and we're solving for x. Now, can we walk through what y'all did to solve for x in this equation?
First, we subtracted 5 from both sides.
And why did you subtract 5 from both sides?
In order to isolate the 9x on one side and keep the equation balanced.
Nice. And what's 50 minus 5?
45.
Okay. Now, how would you isolate the x?
We divided by 9 from both sides.
Nice. So x is equal to 45 divided by 9, which is
5.
Now let's make sure that we check our answer again by plugging it back in. So 9 times x, which is 5, plus 5 equals, 9 times 5 is?
45.
45 plus 5 is?
50.
Yay, so 50 equals 50, and we know that our answer is right because they're equal to each other. Now, to wrap up, I want us to each learn a chant to help us better remember how to solve two-step equations. So, I want y'all to repeat after me. When you do the one step, you do the opposite.
When you do the one step, you do the opposite.
First, you find the variable and ask how you isolate it. Adding and subtracting. Subtracting and adding. Multiplying and dividing. Dividing and multiplying. One step, two step, everyone get to the board. Let me see you 1-2 solve. I love it when you 1-2 solve. Everybody 1-2 solve.
Great
job. Thank you so much.